Fall leaf color is present in the leaves all year round, but it is actually masked by the chlorophyll during the spring and summer. When the days start getting shorter and the temperatures get colder, then the tree starts cutting off nutrients to the leaf. Normally, chlorophyll breaks down all the time and then it's replenished, but once the tree starts cutting off that nutrient level, then the chlorophyll, it breaks down as it normally does, but it just can't be replenished. So, like a mask during Halloween, the chlorophyll comes off and you see the other pigments that are normally present in the leaf. You can think of oranges and yellows as the carotenoids, like carrots, carotene, and then the reds are anthocyanin, and they come out after. Tree species change and become the same color pretty regularly every year, and so hickories will be usually yellow, and then sassafras will be usually yellow with red spots, and red maples will be red, and sugar maples will be orange. So if you learn the different colors that the trees will change, then that's a really great way to help you identify trees at a distance. And one of my favorite colors that happens during the fall is the dogwood, and that turns a really recognizable pink color. Like that tree right there is a dogwood, and no other trees really have that pink color with the leaf shape. So that's a great way to identify trees is by their color. With all the beautiful trees and hills, rolling hills, and different activities to do, Brown County is a great place to come for fall color. And the trees are really, really bright this year, even though there was a drought, but they're incredibly bright. So we hope that a lot of people can come and enjoy this with us. And there's so many things to do and so many things to see. You can go to a vista and look out and see all the different colors. You can go on one of the many hiking trails or go trail riding and just experience the colors a multitude of different ways.